systemic. It affects all the organs, all the systems, and even tissue, because connective tissue is widely distributed almost all of the organs. If it is affected, almost any organ may suffer from it. The other important thing is inflammation.
Also,
is autoimmune on in general. Immunological response. But now we will focus on rheumatic fever itself. Acute rheumatic fever. This is the cause by this so-called classification introduced in the world as a theory of understand each other in heavy language. Again, it is a systemic immune ascending inflammatory disease or disease, which develops as a development sequence, but this is one more important thing of streptococcal infections. Streptococcus. slightly more frequently chorea or affection of nervous system develops in females. I just simply did not find a picturesque photo of women with this condition. Skin affection. Rheumatic fever has its own more or less specific, at least typical, manifestations from side of the skin. If you observe such a round shape, sometimes with covering this square, sometimes located on the one piece with a greyish or pale in the center, this might be one of the possible clinical manifestations of this condition. And other organs might be affected. For example, lungs in form of induced sclerosis. For example, liver, other particular organs of the GAT, that's the standard prep, also in form of diffuse affection of what? Of connective tissue. And it is distributed all over the organism. Besides part of affection, there may be also systemic vasculitis. And this might have a very strong implication to your future work as a specialist in stomatology, because in this condition there is increased predisposition to hemorrhages and disturbance of cortex of all the tissues in oral cavity as well. Predisposition to periodontitis and other conditions. Synonyms of this condition, synonyms of acute rheumatic fever. As we already discussed, sometimes it is associated with rheumatism or with rheumatic disorder, but we only agree with that. Rheumatic disorder is a name for a wide spectrum of different diseases, not only acute rheumatic fever. It is just one of the most prominent, most frequent representatives of this group of rheumatic disorders. But Sofolovsky Bujor disease, it is named by authors, by doctors, scientists who established special symptoms, special mechanisms, classifications for this disease, and historically it might be named by this. This might be. Oh, sorry, excuse me. It might have different clinical forms, carditis itself, and bowel disease, or chorea, or as we discussed with you, arthritis and other things. Pay special attention to this slide. I tried to make it more, some kind of joyful cheerful. I just wanted you to remember you better. There is a special reason. Developed in this condition, acute rheumatic fever, is insidious. Why? Because it leads joints. What do we see? Joints that are affected by rheumatic process usually do not undergo irreversible changes. Usually, joints may got swollen, may represent pain, hypertension, but in 1 month or less or more, this will disappear and nothing will happen to this patient. But this disease bites the heart fundamentally. It is dangerous because of this. It is insidious, but it is dangerous from point of view of heart affection. Why? I suppose that the aim of this lecture, I will illustrate this as much enough for you. On this slide, you might observe some general principles or issues on epidemiology, distribution, incidence of this prevalence of this disease. You may see that it is mostly distributed in those places, in those countries and regions where the humidity of the air is high, where there is a poor state of like, social state, financial, economical state. And therefore, this predisposes to what? Getting ill with or infected by streptococcus type. is much longer in age more than 30. So I'm already 38 years old, so I'm not in risk, but you should think about the probability. Think about it. Next, gender. As you can see, it is much more frequent in females, in women, than in men. What is the reason? It is not strictly, it is not finally revealed, but it is explained by the peculiarities of immunity, the peculiarities of genetics, of hormonal state form, hormonal parents. The parents of this major histocompatibility complex is also adopted. So, anyway, we have such peculiarities. As you can see in females, it mostly is represented in forms of affection of nervous system and mitochondrial. Sometimes very strong expressed types of mitochondrial. In men, is not so frequent, mostly our stimulus, but it's just comparatively. Anyway, in most cases of acute rheumatic fever, it is complicated by mitral infection and mostly mitral stenosis, and I'm going to illustrate this for you slightly. Next, the total general incidence through all the world is about 5 cases per each 100,000 people of population. About 20 million new cases is diagnosed annually in the world. Just imagine this. 20 million new cases of acute rheumatic fever. It seems to be about 30% of these new cases develop complications, chronic complications. So there is almost already no rheumatic disease, acute rheumatic fever itself, but complication in the form of acquired valvular disease, in form of systemic vasculitis, in form of affection of varicose organs, in form of affection of nervous system and other conditions, remain to be present in these people, unfortunately. Next, it is about 3% of untreated sore throats who later in a few weeks, up to 3 weeks approximately, develop this acute rheumatic fever. So if we calculate, if there are 100 persons with sore throat, just usual, they cannot be sure this is viral or bacterial acute infection. And this might be bacterial, this bacterial infection might be of streptococcal nature, this streptococcal infection might result in acute rheumatic fever. So there is a rather high danger. Next, one third result from the same infection. Results from infection, but there is strict, clear clinical evidence association of acute rheumatic fever development and preceding infection is stated in about one third part of all patients. Next, up to 50% of all cardiac conditions are more or less associated with consequences of acute rheumatic fever itself. That the dominant location, locus morbi, is heart infection, first of all, and inside the heart is endocarditis and natural histocompatibility complex. HLA is human leukocyte antigen system. Maybe you have studied this in immunology, microbiology and immunology department. So in other words, there are some predisposition, genetic predisposition, plus social power, as we discussed with you. If person does not have the possibility to undergo timely and correct treatment, the risk of complication of streptococcal infection with rheumatic fever is higher. Very simple association. If he his financial state, his economical state is low, poor, he also is exposed to some risk factors. Hypervitaminosis and others, and immune depression, and possible autoimmune responses. Etiology. It was stated in 1986 that the association, the relationship, or relation of beta-athletic streptococcus type A and acute rheumatic fever is so close that we can afford and manage and force this disease to disappear only in case if this bacteria stops this existence at all. As long as it persists, as it is present and infects, the risk of rheumatic fever remains to be more or less high. Next thing that I also wanted to discuss with you is dedicated to motivation, your motivation to study this exact topic. What is the reason? As we discussed with you at the very first lecture in this subject, there are three main reasons for stomatological students to study internal medicine, internal disease, or disease of internal organs. One is the fact that there could be some emergency. Happen with your patients, with this one, and you bring an emergency related to condition of his internal organs, and you should be able to apply first medical aid before emergency comes, maybe some specialist, some doctor specialized in the field will start his work. From this point of view, acute rheumatic fever might be associated with acute or chronic heart failure. This is the main reason. Besides this, there might be also acute or chronic pulmonary edema with respiratory insufficiency. So, two conditions, pulmonary edema resulting in respiratory insufficiency. And in some more conditions not related to internal medicine, for example, some neurological disorders, with loss of consciousness, with stress, with also infection of respiratory muscles and possibly asphyxia, but it is not really connected with internal medicine itself. The next reason for you to study internal medicine is what? The understanding of relationship between the condition of internal organs and teeth and in general oral cavity. For example, if some person has chronic gastritis, gastroesophageal reflux disease, this will directly, this will, in all cases, directly affect his oral cavity, and he will come to you, and you will treat him. Until you understand the real cause of it, your treatment will not be successful. genesis pathophysiology, but the like main things for you. Next slide. First, this specific stain of bacteria. There is some problem with this.
Small description of general stages, phases.
besides infection of parts, joints, nervous system, and skin, they could be also induce infection of other serious layers, yeah? Membranes. Pleuritis, pleuritis in the belt, peritonitis, and other conditions. Then, nervous system infection. Covid, colitis, and vasculitis, systemic vasculitis, nephritis. Of course, if vessels, small vessels are affected, this might have consequences from the side of kidneys. Pneumonia. Before pneumonia, there might be other conditions, pulmonary edema, there might be fibrosis, and pneumonia is a complication of COVID. Dermatosis, and so on, and outcomes of pharmacology, some complications from them as well. So there's a cascade, you might have a cascade of different changes. For example, cardiac infection, they might be myocarditis, acute myocarditis, then endocarditis with valvular disorders, then compensatory hypertrophy dilation of myocardium in certain locations, we'll discuss that later. Then, on this background, decompensation and heart failure. On this background, pulmonary edema. On this background, complication with secondary partial infection. On this background, respiratory insufficiency. On this background, there is systemic hypoxemia and hypoxia, and diffuse systemic infection of all